Welcome to this video. In this video, we are going to see VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP and XLOOKUP index match functions. Right. Now, we are going to the next one, the LOOKUP function. The LOOKUP function is very helpful to see or to find some data from the existing data set. Let us assume the data set is very huge data set. You see, for example, this one is a 30 data sets are there, data table, data rows are there. Even though it is 30, we have to browse up and down to see a particular data, isn't it? So instead, I want to give only the product code. If I'm giving S1226, it should display this one, the description. Otherwise, if I'm giving this data, automatically the January, February sales amount should be displayed with help of the VLOOKUP, vertical lookup, because the data is formatted in a vertical way, right? So if you want to look at the particular value, if you are searching for a specific value, we have to search in a vertical way, isn't it? Horizontally, we cannot move and see. It is an appropriate view. So only we have to look at vertical way. So, for that purpose, the VLOOKUP is helpful. You see, if you want to give the product code, I want to see the January value. So, here in the VLOOKUP function, VLOOKUP is, you see, I am showing the formula equal to VLOOKUP. If you are start typing the VLOOKUP formula, VLOOKUP, automatically the formula is displaying and the description also will be displayed. So, what the description is saying? Looks for the value in the leftmost column of the table, in the sense this is the leftmost column. Very specifically, what is the value you are looking for, the relevant, that should be in the leftmost, and it returns the value in the same row from a column you are in the ascending order, you search in the ascending order. So the two things we should understand: what the value you are looking for, this relevant information. So that column should be leftmost. And one more thing, the data should be in the ascending order. So these are the two criteria we have to notice. Clear? So by practice, we can easily understand that. I will show you the pronunciation. Just click VLOOKUP. You type manually, otherwise double click this VLOOKUP. Now it is showing the syntax. It is asking one variable, the second variable, the third one, the fourth one. The fourth one is within bracket, so this is optional. We can use or we can leave. The first one is the lookup value. What value are you looking for? I am looking for this value, the first column value. Okay, so where it is located? Somewhere in this column. Which one you are looking for? Yes, 1, 2, 4. You pick up that value. Okay, you take that value. Next one is table array. So where is the table array? So this should be the table array. You can choose any columns, any number of columns, but your lookup value column also supposed to be there. That column should be the leftmost column. Okay. And index number. I am selecting this one. I am choosing this area. I am looking for the January column value. So January column is nothing but index number. You got it? So these are the three things. In this January column, are you looking for the approximate value or exact value? That is comes in the within bracket. So four criteria. Clear? Now see, I am looking for one value. Lookup for. What you are looking for? I am looking for one value, any one of the value. Yes, 1, 2, 4. Yes, 1, 2, 4 is here. Just for your understanding purpose, I am highlighting this column. Right. So, S124 is this column. What you want to see? I want to see January sold amount. I want to see January sold amount. This is the January sold amount. Where it is? This is January sold amount. Okay, so this is the column actually I am looking for. Okay, so Where is the formula? What is the formula? We look up. See, first we have to select this one. We have to decide the lookup value. Then on which column you want to searching for the relevant information, that column you have to identify. Then we have to tell the system that my operation going to be happen in this array. Or you can extend the column. You can extend the column or you can extend full column. No issues, but you cannot. Okay, we are searching this. That also should be the part of your array. You select this one or extend. Okay. Now see, what is the formula? Equal to B lookup. I'm not typing, I'm selecting this. You can type also, no issues. Lookup values, yes, 124. Select that. And the next variable, comma. Where is the table? So this is the table. You need not select the titles. You see, I'm selecting. This is a table. You can choose the complete table or you can select the part of the table. Now select it. Now put comma. Now see, second variable also filled up, taken. Next one, index. Index is nothing but on which column you want to finding, you want to search. I want to search in this column. This column number 1, 2, 3. It is not start from 0. Starts from 1. 1, 2, 3. Third column. You put 3 here. Right. What is the next one? Column index is okay. Now put comma. Now it is asking for the range lookup. Are you looking for the approximate or exact match? I want to search for the exact match because this is not the ascending order. It is randomly, but even though it is random, I am looking for the exact value. Now you have to select the false. You type false or even you can type 0 also. Close the bracket and say enter. See, now it is saying 5371. Are we getting this value? Isn't it? So this is the way we can do that. For example, instead of 124, if you are selecting 126, this value should be. Okay. So here, instead of S124, I am selecting S126. Now look at this value. It changed to 8378. 8378 is here. You see, here it is. I am not looking for the January. I am looking for the total. Okay. So you select this. You change the index number. The index number, the total is outside the array, so we cannot search for the total, right? Only up to selected area only we can give the number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 columns can be given. Now I am searching for the March. March is index is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I give 5 here and click enter. Now see, I have given 126. This is the 126. And I searched for S126. S126 is fifth column. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4496. You see this one. So that is the way we can see that. So this is vertical lookup. We are looking for a value with a reference in a vertical manner. Is vertical lookup. Okay. So here, instead of this value changing every time, I want to select any one of the value. How we can make use of list. You keep the mouse pointer here, go to data validation, select the first one. What you want to use here? I want to make it as a list. You select the list. What is the range of the list? You select the red point and select from this point to last point. Hold control shift and download arrow. The complete being selected. Now see that our reference also given here. You just select the, you click on the red point. The data is reflecting here. Now you can simply say okay. Okay, now see, we are getting the list here. You just click this, you can see all the data here. You need not type, you can select that 128, FS 128. You can see somewhere it is located. So we are hiding this and we can unhide. I am hiding this, hide, and this also I am hiding. Hide and see, we are able to see this one simply by using this. We can change any column, we can see this, even index also we can change to anyone. We can see this unhiding. You select these columns, you unhide, you can get all the columns here. Also, M1OP and P is hidden. No, you select O and Q, keep the mouse pointer here, unhide, we can see that one. So this is the way we can make use of data validation in a different innovative applications. Okay, now we are moving to the hedge lookup. So what are the hedge lookup? What we tried with the horizontal vertical way, the same thing we can do it. See, I'm selecting these columns, control shift downward arrow, completely I have chosen that, and control C is for copy. Now I am going to the next one more fresh shade. Keep the mouse pointer here, going to here, paste special. What you want to transpose, see all values simply displayed in the transposed way. All titles, you see all titles. What are the titles? The description, I have chosen only this one, right? So description January, February, March. So this complete thing come to the left side. All vertical data copy to horizontal side, right? So that is what this shows. The same data I copied from this point to that point, I copied and I pasted here. So this is happened like this. Okay, so here the data are in the vertical, we are searching in the vertical way. Here the data in the horizontal, we have to search in the horizontal. Apart from that, the formula is a small difference. What is the small difference? Instead of VLOOKUP, we have to type the HLOOKUP. See, HLOOKUP. What it is saying? The same way. So there we have to use the column reference number and column index. Here we have to use the row reference and the row index number. The lookup value, what we are looking for, this value. And what is the array? This is the array. So array, you need not select the column title. Here the row title. You select this and come down and write out arrow. See, complete data set is selected and put comma. Now we have to give the index. So what index we are searching for? I want to search for the total. Okay, total is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You give 6. And is it exact or approximate? I'm going with the false. So false can be typed directly or 0 also can be given. See, so this is given. What are the values? C0124. Where is the C0124? This is C0124. And what is the column? It is displaying the total index. See, 27493 is displayed. So same VLOOKUP, but the only difference is the data is horizontal. We are using HLOOKUP. Any formula difference? No. Column number, instead of the column number, you have to give the row reference number. That's it. So this is the HLOOKUP. Now we are moving to the match function. Is the same kind of, in the same way, HLOOKUP and VLOOKUP, but here this will be helpful to look up. The match function simply looks up an item and reports the relative position of an item in the list. For example, this is the item, this is the list of the item. What we are looking for? I am looking for one value, SD. Okay, so where it is located and which place it is located? 1, 2, 3 is a 1, 2, third position. So it should give the position number as 3. So that is the use of the index number. So the position number will be given by the index. Okay, so what we are looking for? Bullet or SD. You can select anything, bullet or SD, anything, the same. We have seen now how we can implement the list. So here we are going to type the formula. So what the formula? We can type equal to match is the formula, the match function, match. Here we can given the syntax also. Match approximates, looks for the value, sorted, descending, ascending, that value. I will explain that. So match function, I am right click that. First one is lookup value. What value are looking for? This value. And where it is available? Array. So this is the array from this point to this point. I am selecting, this is the array. Okay, so if you have to go with the exact match, you have to give the 0. I want to go with the exact match. You just type 0 and click enter. It is showing that 8. Commit some mistake. Here you see, The B5 is one variable. There's a one parameter that we are telling that is a parameter lookup value, right? That's a B5 that is given. The next one is array. We have to choose these values. These values are nothing but the B10 to B14. What we have given B10 to B14, instead of that it becomes 140. We forget to put comma. You just put comma and click enter. Now we are seeing the exact answer 3. Here you see the SD, the 1, 2, 3, the third one is the SD. So here also it is showing that the index of the lookup value is 3 in the taken array. So this is what the match function doing. Okay, to find out the index in the sense sequence number where it is located in the particular taken array. So that is the use of the match function. One thing we have to understand is what we have to give, 0 or some other number, exact or approximate. So this one is exact. Now how it will be working in case of approximate, you see, we are coming to the next one. Here also same type of value given. These values are in the ascending order, right? Smaller to bigger. So in case the taken array is in ascending order, we have to give 1 as the index value. See, here we are looking for the 1250. 1250 is somewhere around 1000 beyond the limit. The match function equal to match, double click. We are looking for this lookup value, comma. The array is, you select the array, comma. So what we are looking for, we tried with the exact match 0, right? Now the remaining things are 1 or minus 1. So what is this 1 or minus 1? The 1 in the sense the array, taken array is in ascending order, we can give 1. Okay, otherwise we can omit also. Even if you are not giving any this parameter, it will be considered that the taken array is in ascending order. Okay, so we will give 1 here and close the bracket or simply click enter. Now see, the taken value 1250 lies in the fifth category, fifth range. Index is 5. 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, and this is 5. But here we have taken the 1250. 0 to 100 is 0. 100 to 250 is this one, second one. 250 to 500 is this one, third one. 500 to 1000 is fourth one. 1000 and above is 5. Okay, so that is why it is showing 5. The 1250 comes under this category, 1000 and above category. 1000 and above is index is 5. See, instead of this, on the 1250, if you are giving 99, see, I am changing here 99. Now see, what it is saying? 0 to 100, this 99 also comes under the first index. So that is why it is giving first. In case of 300 in the sense, you see, I am giving 300 here. The 300 generally it comes around 250 to 500 range. So 1, 2, 3, 3 should be come over here. See, it becomes 3. So that is how this ascending order, this approximate in ascending order sequence is working. In case this order is in the descending order, by the time we have to give the minus 1. Okay, now we are coming to this next one. The same kind, 15 to 10 is one category, 10 to 5 is another category. This is the way. Okay, 1 and below is this category in the reverse order. That means it is in the descending order. In case of descending order, here the match function equal to match, double click. And the lookup value is 7 inch, comma. The range is, you select the range, comma. Now what we have to give? 0 we cannot give because we are not going for the exact value. It is not in the ascending order. So 1 also rooted out. Next one is minus 1 because this is in the descending order. Give minus 1 and click enter. Now see, it is giving 2. 7 inches, 10 to 15 is this range. Okay. 1 or less than 1 is 5. 1 to 3 is 4. 3 to 5 is this one. 5 to this one is 10 is second. 10 to 15 is 5. 5 to 10 in between 7 is lies. So it comes to second one. The index is 2. Now see, instead of the 7, you just give 1. It is coming 5. It is coming 5. This is a 5. Okay. And so this is the way the match function is working. Now we are going to use VLOOKUP. The one more, the index function also is there, index and match. So what are the indexing, index function will be doing? The index function is helping us to find one way lookup, to find, see, in case if you are taking this, the same example, product is, we are taking index, but and that product, the relevant information we need, what we are looking, see in the previous, the match function, we have taken that value and we are searching the value in the same array. We have taken the 300, we are searching in the same array, but I want to search for Honda cost. Let us assume this is a Honda, this is a low Honda cost. I'll be giving Honda, but I have to pick up the 100. So this is one identifier, this is another identifier. So here the same way we have to use multiple column. I am going to give the one ID, the relevant, the price, otherwise relevant product number should be taken. So here index and match function should be implemented. So that is what we are going to do in the combination. You see, I am taking SD, and what is the total price? The total price is SD. This is the total price. And one more thing you have to notice, in case of VLOOKUP, if you are taking that the lookup value, that should be in the leftmost column, but here we are taking the right column. That means we are breaking the rule which the VLOOKUP lookup is following, correct? So this is the exact, this is the SD. Instead of this SD, I am taking Honda. Now Honda is a second one, that is in this column, but I am going to extract the price from the previous column. Now see, here we can use the index and match function. So how we can do? First, index function, it returns the value of the reference of the cell at the intersection of the particular row and column in a given range. So double click that array. So first we have to select the array. So where is the array? B10 to B14. See, B10 to B14. Here it is. Okay, this is the index. In this place only we are going to find out. Next one, where we are going to match? Somewhere. So what is the location? The, we have taken the Honda. Honda is this one, the 1, 2. So the second, this 5. First of all, we have to find out the number 2. In the 2, the corresponding, the value should be taken. You got it? First are 1, 2, 3. That value will be found out by the match function. That found value will be used to find out the value of the price of the Honda. Okay, Honda are variables. See, we have chosen this as the first variable and put comma. Now we can implement the match function. You type match, the match is here, double click this, the match function comes up. So match value, what is the value we are actually looking for? I am looking for this value, Honda. Okay, and where is the array? The Honda is available here. And what we are looking for, whether it is the exact value or what, this is in, is there any order we are maintaining? No, it simply gives 0. Double closing bracket, because we have opened 2 bracket. No, here it is 1, here is another. So close 2 times and click enter. Now see, it is giving Honda is 29.75. See, Honda 27.95, isn't it? So instead of Honda, you pick up some other value, bullet. It's 19.95. Are we getting that? Yes. So this is the way the match and index will be working. Shall we go to one more thing? So here we are going to do one more exercise. Example equal to index. Okay. Double click. And what we can give? This is the array. This is the array. Isn't it? So this is the array, comma. Now we can give the match function. Match, you type match and take the match function. So in the match function, what we are going to look, lookup value is 7. And where is the 7 available? In this array. You put comma and select this array. Okay. And now this array, is in ascending or descending? It is in the descending order. So we can use minus 1. Equal minus 1. Close double time brackets. Enter. Now see 7 inches. 7 inches is 10 to 5 in the sense. The 7 comes around this value. This in between. So that should be in this one. So this value should be picked up. See 83,000 is coming here. Clear? So like this, the match index function will be working. So this match function we can use with the VLOOKUP also. See, this is one example. We are going to see one more example to understand this. Okay, or simply double click, it will be adjusting. No need to manually do this. Right. So here one is given, A1. This is the roll number. We are giving roll number. Then I have to pick up subject. You can choose any subject. Then marks will be displayed. See, already A1 is there. This is the A1. In this accounts marks, this column, A1 accounts mark is 100. This is what it is showing here. Okay. See, for A1, instead of A1, I am selecting A6. You select A6. Which subject mark you want to see? I want to see the marketing. You select the marketing here. This is a marketing 15. You see A6 marketing. This is the marks. It is displaying. What is the formula we are using? See, here is a formula. VLOOKUP. What is the subject you are seeing? The lookup value. The lookup value is this one. I3. This is the 1, 2, 3. No, I3. I3 value. Then where is the range available? This is A1 to E1. We have chosen this, and of course the titles, if you are putting check mark, it will not be considered at the time of evaluation. So this is the array value. The next one, what are the index you are looking for? The match function, the index is we are using this one, A3. This one is A3. Where it is available? A3 in this one, so that we can find out the index. In that index, which array? In this array, that indexed array, this value will be extracted as appropriate value. Okay. So this is how the lookup as well as match function will be working. You change this and just analyze this. Easily we can understand match function, match index along with the lookup function. So the match index function is a little bit advanced version of VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP. What we are not able to do in VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, that can be overcome with help of the index and match function. Okay, right. And one more function also is there, that is a XLOOKUP. Any row we can choose, any row value also we can see. So that is what XLOOKUP. See, this is the table we have taken example. I am choosing the table title in a different color for easy understanding purpose. Okay, so this is equal to XLOOKUP. There is no XLOOKUP. That is why we are not getting any suggestion. XLOOKUP is the very recently introduced by the Excel, hardly around 4-5 months only. Okay, so if you want to execute the XLOOKUP, you have to go to Office 365. If you have Office 365, you can do that. Otherwise, the latest version, you can do that. I have Office 365 account. So now I am going to Office 365 Excel. I am opening this Excel sheet from Office 365. And this is the data. And copying this data, Control C, I am going to Excel 365 is here. Okay, I am just pasting this, pasting the same value. Okay. Right, now see, we are using XLOOKUP. You just type XLOOKUP, you see, it is showing. Because this latest version is available in 365. If you are having Office 17 or 16 version, you can see this. Okay, if it is the latest version, then only we can see this. What the prompt message is telling? Searches a range or an array for a match and return the corresponding item from the second range or array. By default, an exact match is sent. Exact match by default, it will be taking the exact match. Right, I am double clicking this. What is the lookup value? The lookup value is, right. So what you want to look up? I want to pick up Delhi. That is a lookup value equal to x lookup. Lookup value is this one, Delhi, and lookup array is this one, and a return value array. I want to return value from this array and click enter. Samuel. Where is the Delhi? This is a Delhi. The Delhi first name is Samuel. You see, I am taking this as an array and I want to look up from this array. So you can choose any column and any row. The previously in the lookup table, the VLOOKUP table, what are the criteria? They should be, this must be leftmost column, isn't it? This data is supposed to be this side. Then only we can see the lookup value. But here there is no required. You can keep your lookup value this side. You can keep it, or this also can be moved somewhere. You can specify this value. You see, right now this is a Delhi. Instead of Delhi, you can select this, go to data, and data validation, you select the value as list, and the range, the source range, the source range is from this point to this point. You select this, say okay, and see, you can select anyone. Instead of the Delhi, you can see Kolkata. The corresponding, the name Rakesh, the Rakesh is Kolkata. Okay, it's a 1, it's a 2, it is 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8. The same way here also. Okay, so we are taking the fifth one, Patna. Patna here, Patna. And the Patna is this one. The Patna is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you know. The fifth 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Manish. You see, here it is Manish. So this is the way the X lookup is working. Clear? I hope this video is very helpful for you. Thank you for watching.